Good day, everybody. Once again, it's your man, C. Mill, C from the D, coming at you with everything that's real. How you doing? How you doing, COL? How you doing? Today is a great day in the name of Jesus Christ. Today, your man, C. Mill, would like to talk to you about 10 reasons why the narc thinks that people are out to abuse them. 10 reasons. Number one, they think that people are like them. They think that people are mischievous, undermined, and demonic like them. So that's why they think they're going to get you before you get them. Number two, they look at everybody as competition. They look at everybody as competition, which is crazy. That is crazy. You got some real psychological things going on. Oh, narcissistic psychopath. Number three, they have a very high level of anxiety. Very high level of anxiety. They are always worried about who's going against them, or who's talking down against them, who going against them in prayer, who going against them in spiritual warfare. They got a high level of anxiety. They never feel comfortable, you know what I'm saying, despite that fake persona that they try to uphold. Nah, they full of crap, man. They full of crap. Number four, they think that other people are fake just like them. They think that other people are fake, just like they know they fake, because they know they don't like you, and they know they don't like a lot of people that's around them, hovering around them, however you want to call it, or trying to get their validation. They know they fake. You know, they look at them as fake because they know they fake. They know they don't like none of the people they dealing with. The nerd don't care nothing about, they don't even care about their kids. They just using their kids to have a future in future slaves. You know what I'm saying? Number five, they think that the narc wants to make you feel bad on purpose. So they think that your intentions are like theirs, because they want to make you feel bad on purpose. You know, the push-pull method, you know what I'm saying, to establish dominance and make you feel like you have to win their checkbox of validation. You know what I'm saying? Which, no, it shouldn't be like. If it's like that, then it's toxic. Get away from them. Number six, they think that domination and control is the only way to win, the only way to feel secure, and they live in constant fear. They think that domination, so for me to be around you, you have to feel dominant over me, or you're going to think that I'm trying to go against you. Ain't that some BS? You don't have to try to dominate me. I'm not out to dominate you. That's crazy that they think like that. That's total craziness, you know. That's some psychopathic, narcissistic stuff. Number seven, the narc is always out to prove that you are not better than them. The narc is always out to prove that you are not better than them. Ain't that crazy? Ain't that crazy? Who the hell cares? You know what I'm saying? It ain't even about that. You know what I'm saying? Better than anybody. Ain't nobody better than nobody, man. Be the best that you could be. You in competition with the old you. That's it. The part of you where you failed or you messed up, that's about it. But as far as somebody else, you don't be in competition with nobody else. That's so sadistically sick and demonically inclined. Number eight, the narc is always out to prove and present you as a bad person. They know in their heart that they mean nobody no good, so they think that you on the same thing. They have done so many bad things against you and everybody that they deal with. They are on some straight sabotage.com, so they think you gonna do that to them. That's one of the reasons that the narc thinks that people are out to get them, because that's what they out to do. They out to sabotage you and everybody around them. You know what I'm saying? Anybody that's hanging with the narc, you in for a rude awakening, because the narc already, you know what I'm saying, they like the Scorpio on the frog's back. They gonna stab you sooner or later. The narc does not trust anyone, and especially don't trust and respect the flying monkeys or anyone that they got to go against the target. They are already looking at the flying monkeys and the people they use to go against the target as untrustworthy. The only way the narc looks at you is a traitor and untrustworthy. And the narc thinks all of you, they just seen all of you stab somebody in the back, him or her in the back. And they think in their mind, you think I'm gonna give you a chance or opportunity to do the same thing to me, the same thing you did to him or her. The narc, which is a snake, already looks at everybody that joined them in their pursuit of the target as a snake. And they think in their head, I would never give them the chance to bite me or stab me in the back. The narc does not trust anyone to help them go against their target. Anybody that traded on somebody, anybody that went against somebody else that was a good person, and the narc knows how good the person was being to them and to the flying monkeys, the narc look at you as weak, insignificant, pile of snot. They do not trust you, worth nothing. You know what I'm saying? Worth nothing. The narc already seen what they got you to do. They already seen they manipulated you, so they think somebody else will manipulate you against them. They don't trust you. So they just gonna, over time, they just gonna treat you worse. They gonna treat you worse and treat you bad, because they already don't trust you. They already don't want you around them, because they already seen you trade on somebody that was a good person. So the narc does not trust any of the flying monkeys or any specific people they use to go against the target. And number 10, one of the 10th reason that the narc does not think that, I mean, 10 reasons why the narc thinks that people are out to abuse them is, number 10 is, the narc doesn't believe that there are any genuine good people out there. They think everybody is underhanded and cutthroat like them. They don't believe in anybody's genuality or anybody's real love. The narc is sick and twisted and needs a lot of help. Some of them can't be helped. Some of the demons have such a stronghold on them. Some of them got 50 demons on them. It's up to the narc to get in touch with God. And that's the only way. You know what I'm saying? That's the only way. Once again, this is your man, C. Mill. C from the D, coming at you with everything that's real. Y'all have a blessed one. Hit that like and subscribe. You know what I'm saying? Share the videos with anybody that's in help. I appreciate y'all. Thank you to all the new subscribers. Welcome to the family. I appreciate y'all. Hey, positive energy is the best energy. Remember that.